Test 1, 2, test, test 3, test, 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 test. Yeah.
Ooh la la.
All right, folks, you have arrived at a daily vlog channel where I film life, film with my family, film my yard work. I'm looking out at my yard right now. I'm in my shed, actually. This is my recording studio. And basically, a big part of my life is running. I love running. I've been running since I was in sixth grade, so what was I, like 12 years old, 11 years old? I don't know. I was young. So I've been running my whole life, and I ran in high school, ran in college, took a little time off after college where I was not running much. And then, okay, I'm 33 now, about the age of 28, I started running again and getting back into it slowly. And so now I'm getting into ultra running, long distance running. Long miles. I ran 25 miles yesterday. I thought I was going to put this shoe on, the Salomon S Lab Ultra. I actually ran away from my car, so I couldn't get back. I ran in the Salomon Speed Cross instead. But I thought I was going to throw this guy on, but I went the wrong direction. So anyway, story for another day. Basically, this is not my review of the Salomon S Lab Ultra. This is just my initial impression after taking them through the, well, I opened them up a couple days ago. And then today I put them on my feet. Kind of get those shoelaces all figured out. You know how you put new shoes on and you got to figure out the shoelaces. Well, I did that, got feeling good, and then started jogging. And now this is a trail shoe. This is not a street shoe. And I guess, well, okay, I take that back. You could wear this on the street, but it does have a little bit of lug action that probably isn't necessary for road running. It's definitely a trail shoe. But I took it through the streets of Denver, just testing it out. My feet, the first mile, were a little confused, trying to figure out what's this new feel in a Salomon shoe, because this is definitely a different type of Salomon shoe. There's more cushion, definitely more cushion. Now, it's not like a Hoka or a like an Adidas Boost or even like a Nike Epic React. Like, it's not that type of cushion, but it does have more cushion than your typical Salomon. So then by about mile 2.5 today, I started feeling good. Started feeling better, and my feet were figuring out, okay, what's this new shoe all about? Anyway, my initial impression is I'm very, very excited. Now, I'm running a 50K race very soon, meaning in the next 10 days, so that's 32 miles, but it has a lot of vertical. So I think I'm gonna wear this shoe. I'm not positive, because the lugs on the bottom of this guy, these are the lugs, the tread here, it's good lug action, but it's not the biggest lugs you've ever seen on a Salomon shoe. That's the first thing you might notice when you pull it out of the box. And then in September, I'm running a 100-mile race in Steamboat Springs, Run Rabbit Run. This will definitely be one of the shoes that I wear. So, why have I transitioned a little bit to Salomon in 2018, whereas in 2017 I was definitely more of a Hoka guy? Well, I like quality. I like Hoka's overall design. I think their approach to cushion is attractive to me because I have struggled in the past with injuries, specifically stress fractures of my bones. So once I found Hoka and the cushion, I was like, okay, this is good. But then I realized, wait a minute, these Hoka shoes are like breaking down after 150 miles, meaning the uppers, this is the upper of the shoe where on the top here, it was breaking down after 150 miles. And I'm like, what is going on? Like, I can't afford to buy new Hokas every, you know, month. And so, Salomon, I must tip my cap to you, because I know that this shoe will last at least 500 miles if I wanted it to. I just know that based on the material. Unless I go like absolutely insane in the mountains in these, like nasty, nasty terrain, off-trail stuff, maybe they wouldn't make it 500 miles. But overall, I'm excited. And of course, what I like personally the best about Salomon is that you get a good old bear hug when you put this thing on because of the lacing system. It's the lacing system that just I love. And when you're running 100 miles in a race, you actually don't want to stop at an aid station for too long to change your shoes. And so with these guys, you don't have to untie and tie your shoes. You just pull this guy like that. So, bottom line, I'm excited, Salomon. Thank you for getting these to me pretty quickly. But I will say, Salomon, you've got competition. What just arrived in the mail today, about 10 minutes ago? The lovely post office dropped this off at my house. Ooh, can you see that? La Sportiva, remember I took second place at a race in Vail on Saturday. Today's Wednesday, so Tuesday, Monday, Sunday. 4 days ago, I got second place. Well, these guys arrived in the mail today because I ordered them that night. I am so excited. Thank you, La Sportiva, for taking care of me so quickly. So, Solomon, watch out. You got competition. I'll give you initial impressions of a La Sportiva tomorrow. All right, folks, that is it. That is today's vlog. I love you guys, and thanks for tuning in. If you like running videos, especially mountain running, hit that subscribe button. I know you'll enjoy what I'm capturing with my GoPro, somewhere, wherever that thing is. Seek beauty, work hard. Thank you, Solomon. Thank you, La Sportiva. Thank you, world! And love each other. See you tomorrow.